Hi, adult people. I'm here with Rex. And I don't really have a whole lot to talk about, I guess. I just wanted to come to you guys and just chat, I guess. I've been doing things, you know, with the dolls, of course, you know. Recently, I just gave him a new face up. His old one was kind of like old and smudgy. It was back when I did his face up, back when I didn't really understand how to use pastels very well. I feel like every doll artist or any person that's attempted to go about a face up or any repaint or anything like that, I mean, of course, you look at your dolls from the past and you see what you did wrong. And then you see the dolls that you've done currently and you're like, that's much more pleasing. So that's just what happened with Rex. I mean, I tried to keep his new face up pretty true to what he was before, because what he was before was aesthetically what I was going for. Like, it was what I was looking for him to be as far as character wise. And that's the funny thing, Rex doesn't even really have very much of a story. He's just kind of like my glorified supermodel, which is what most of my dolls end up being anyway. Like, I'm very fashion forward. I love fashion. I love looks, and I love playing around with looks and fabrics and stuff. But yeah, so I gave him a new face up, and I'll insert pictures. Understand how to use pastels all that well. So I was using predominantly acrylics, and I mean, it was just like a habit that I got from painting fashion dolls, because I would paint the fashion dolls. And the thing is, with fashion dolls, you can of course use tons and tons of pastels and do whatever you wish with your doll, but for what I was using them for, I never even, like, I had pastels. I've always had pastels. Like, I would go to the store and they're so pretty and I'm like, I'm gonna use you one day, and I buy them. So I had pastels, but I just never, like, busted open the box and really tried using them until, you know, I started wanting more out of what I was producing as far as the artwork that was going into the doll. I often go back and look at my older pictures and find ways that I can improve myself. So that's what I was doing. I was going back into my photo stream on Flickr, and I would look at all the old dolls that I thought were cute. And I still have quite a few that I painted in the past that I still think to this day are really cute. But now that I have this really good understanding of pastels, I understand how to use them well. It really does open up this fantastic medium of artwork with your dolls. It really adds something to your dolls. They come alive in different ways. And I didn't really get inspired to do that until, because I found Flickr. You know, I found Flickr, and I seen that there's this huge community of doll collectors. Because for whatever reason, after my grandmother passed, and I was collecting dolls by myself, I just felt really, really alone. I mean, I'm sure I understood that there were doll collectors, but I just didn't feel connected in any way until I found Flickr. You know, when I found Flickr and I got to see not only the fashion dolls that I was collecting at the time, which was like vintage Barbie, Yeah, that's all I was collecting. I was only collecting vintage Barbie. And not only did I see this huge community that were collecting vintage Barbies, but they were collecting Pulits and BJDs and all these other types of dolls that I hadn't really been introduced to through my grandmother. As all the other amazing dolls that I now have in my collection, I had no clue existed. So, you know, lurking online, trying to really see pictures of repaints, because this was around the time, 2007, 2008, was around the time when I got really bored, like really bored with the dolls that I had. They just didn't, they weren't doing what they were doing when I was younger. When I was younger, I'd get a doll, it'd be fine. I'd be just as happy as I am now with my collection. But as I got older, it was like I demanded more from the specific doll. And, you know, I had this idea. I'd seen pictures already of people repainting dolls. They would pop up every once in a while when I would Google Barbies and such. But I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know how to get rid of the face that was already on the doll. It was a lot of learning that I had to do, and through all of that digging and learning that I went through online, I found a couple Yahoo blogs with people posting their pictures of their beautiful dolls that I didn't know what they were, but I found a community, and I found people that were just as talented as I already knew that I was. I've always been an artist. I was in a place where I was trying to connect the talent that I already had with my love of dolls. I found these people that had already done that, and they were creating these amazing dolls. It was just a reinvigoration for doll collecting, a new passion. And I'm really happy to now look up at my collection and can clearly see that I've done what I wanted to do. I wanted to have dolls that I could look at on my shelves and around my home and say that I'm genuinely happy with that doll. And, you know, I continue to do that. I had the time this weekend to work on my Unoa Ray, that's the character's name, Ray, her name's Ray, but my Unoa Lucis, the other faceplate that I have for her, I had a chance to work on it, and I completed it. My first work in progress that I showed you guys in the previous video to this one, it showed like beautiful roses in the center of her face, of her forehead, and like leaves extending from the biggest rose at the top. But I proceeded to seal that head a little bit after I took those work in progress pictures, and it was hella hot in New York City. And it was so humid, and I didn't think to check the humidity. Oh my God. It got really foggy. The ceiling did. It got really foggy, and then after it getting foggy, at first I just figured it was because maybe I sprayed too much sealant, and I was gonna let it cure and see if that would make it better. After maybe 2 hours, I went back to it, and it was still super foggy, but it cracked so bad. It looked like shattered glass, and for a minute, I was like, oh my God, I think I may have cracked up this faceplate. But after I wiped the face, it was just the ceiling, thank God. So I waited a day, and I sprayed it at night. The humidity was very low. And it sealed perfectly like it usually does, and I started over. Of course, I was kind of pissed because I thought the direction I was going with it originally was nice enough already. The concept of what I really wanted for this this faceplate was kind of like I wanted to go in a similar direction that I went with Uni, my little small 24 centimeter Obisu girl. I wanted to go in that direction with all the pretty purples, and you can't really see it in some of the pictures I've taken, but there's blues as well. And then the really beautiful red blush and such. So I wanted to kind of go in that direction with this faceplate, but I also wanted to add roses. Like, roses are really my thing. Like, between roses and elves, those are kind of my thing. And when you mesh those together, it's just always pretty to me. So I did just that. I guess the sealant getting all jacked up in the beginning was a good thing, because she turned out better than I expected her to. And the concept was really solid, and it was just so much fun watching her progress through all the coats of sealant and the different pastels I used to get with her face up. And like, she turned out fantastic. I'm going to also include pictures of her without her wig and with Uni as well. So that was Ray. I'm really happy with the way she turned out. Other dolly news. Today, after completing her face up, completing Ray's face up, I was going through my little box of bodies that we all have in the doll community. Like, if you collect and you're rebodying, like, you have a box of bodies. It just happens. And Andrea sent me a Bratz doll that I showed you guys in, I think, a couple videos before. And the body that she sent the Bratz doll on was a lip body, and it was a darker lip body. So I had since moved that Bratz head onto a made-to-move body, so it left me with this lip body. And I was having a bit of an issue with my jewel hair Barbie. She has all this long hair. Oh my god, I love it. She has this long hair, and I put her on a darker Poppy Parker body made by Integrity Toys. And the thing is, the jewel hair Barbie's face, it kind of gives me teenager, like 14, 15. That's kind of what that face, the face is giving me, and I don't want to repaint her because I love it. So I took out the body Andrea sent me, the lip body, and I popped her head on that body, and it just, she came alive. Just perfect. I dressed her very Dolls Ahoy, because I love the way Andrea's dolls dress, but here she is.
She's so cute! She's so stinking cute!
But yeah, she's like, she's a teenager. But she had tons of hair, and I love her so much. So thank you, Andrea, for sending that Bratz doll on this live body, because you actually helped me complete this girl. But I mean, I guess that's all I have for you guys today. I just wanted to come to you guys and yap, because that's fun. Just wanted to talk. Predominantly dolls. I enjoy this so much, talking about dolls. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for tuning in and watching this video all the way to the end if you have. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video.